Welcome to this parallel session on tourism and environment. This is José Luis Sánchez. I'm lecturer at the University of Malaga, and it's an honor for me to be the chair of this session. Well, we have now only three communication, no four, because one of the our college of the CERS communication can be with us now. So we have enough time for to make a lot of questions then. Well, but, now the first communication. Networking biosphere research through corridor on the basis of the Millennium Ecosystem Assessment. Professor Frodin, the floor is for you.
Thank you. I'm going to try to speak standing. I don't know if you hear me. Up, down, yeah, okay. Talk is not so much about tourism, but we try to give some basis for different approaches involving tourism in natural environments, natural reserves. And then I will more or less the scheme, the structure of the talk is a brief introduction, but we will try to get some conclusions since the beginning, because then at the end I won't be able to finish it. And then we will talk a little bit, not about biosphere research, because I think more or less everybody knows about it, but about the Madrid Action Plan for the UNESCO World Network of Biosphere Research. And then the method the approach that we are going to use to analyze the ecosystem services in biosphere research, and how we can rely on ecosystem services for designing touristic activities or touristic programs, tourist programs. And finally, I will try to propose a model for what should be a new or a different approach to the more general used one in natural environments. That is, instead of the fence approach, that is like these package trips that take you to one side and everything is planned. Instead of that, it's more to get lost in some way. Having a living experience, I don't know how is exactly the name in vivencias en español, and how taking into account just a few places in a network, it is possible to extend this experience, these best available practices, to the whole network. Then, one of the first problems we face with natural biosphere reserves in Spain is that most of them are located in not so representative landscapes or ecosystems. There's mountain, alpine ecosystems, and so on. And just in the central depressions, in the meseta, in the central mesetas, you only find one, that is the Mancha Húmeda Biosphere Reserve. And it was one of the first ones that was declared in 1980, and no more has been declared since then. However, in the Canary Islands, and also in Asturias, north of Spain, you can find plenty of biosphere reserves that have been declared very recently, even in this century, okay? And that's a problem of lack of representativity. Then one of the things that, one of the tasks that is still ahead of us is to try to correct this trend. Of course, taking into account different international figures and different international tools for it. Another problem, and this one is not involving only local population, but also the conservationist people, is the uprooting, disarrival, okay, and the loss of sense of belonging. The people is not so well identified with the wetlands, with the ecosystems that are in the backyard of the house. So that's a big problem here. We have discussed because we have a conservationist in our team. And I say, well, they are kind of pirates, something like that, because these the conservationist groups demanded to retire the condition of biosphere reserve to Mancha Húmeda. And I think this is a lack of responsibility, because the MAGNA biosphere program consider it seriously. And I think that's no good, because, okay, Tablas de Daimiel, that is one of the natural reserves, most important one, is not so well conserved. It was, yeah, later it was, there was a fire in it, but there are plenty of lakes that are in better condition than this one. Then this has to be solved by more research and encouraging this kind of activities. Another problem is the failures in assessment of natural values. In Ciudad Real, very close to Ciudad Real, we have one of these airports that is in the middle of nowhere, and the people who tried to promote this say that this land was not useful for agriculture. There were no forests, of course not. You have all the biosphere reserves in Picos de Europa and Canary Islands, and also in Andalusia, not here, because why? Because the conservationist people is more active in the Canary Islands? No, because in the Canary Islands there are more tourism, and they try to exploit the natural values for tourism, not like in La Mancha. But these people say, okay, we are going to bring here 555 people in one Airbus 380. And what are these people going to do in Ciudad Real? Ciudad Real is not like Toledo. There's nothing to see there. But in the province, there are plenty of natural reserves, very valuable. And I said, okay, yes, let these people go and see the great bustard and see how this is linked to this shire that is Campo de Calatrava. It's a volcanic shire where the lakes for breeding of the great bustard are in heights, here they make this rueda, I don't know how is the name in English, and so on. That's a possibility, that's a real possibility. And actually, the airport has operated better for hunting tourists than for people going to London like me. I said, yeah, okay, when the airport is operating, I will go to London. I went, but just once, because then they close it. Then, of course, the techniques like environmental impact assessment should help with this, not to fail in this kind of things. There are several important, interesting things in the Madrid Action Plan for the global network of biosphere reserves, and I just underline two. That is the challenges and the potential role of biosphere reserves in addressing them, and they talk about the provision of ecosystem services, because this is a tool that they find in UNESCO, in the MAGNA Biosphere Program, to be very interesting to be applied to the biosphere reserves. And the mission of the World Network of Biosphere Reserves within this, the MAGNA Biosphere Program, is to ensure the environmental, economic, social, including cultural and spiritual sustainability through the development of the coordination within a network, okay? That is the fence approach, that is fencing a natural reserve and then visiting what is inside, is not more valid anymore. Then we had in, just going to the boundaries of Castilla-La Mancha region, we could go beyond, of course. We have two natural corridors that are the rivers or the river corridors and the cattle trails, the cañadas, vías pecuarias, that are very important for this. And we have an additional source of connectivity, that is stepping stones connectivity provided by both wetlands, isolated wetlands or steparian wetlands, and also step zones, like the one in important bed area of Campo de Calatrava, where the airport of Ciudad Real is. Then, well, Millennium Ecosystem Assessment, I think, is more and more known, is very utilized today. And there are the last typology consists on three categories, main categories, that are provisioning, regulating and maintenance, and cultural, with those subcategories that you can see in this slide. And one of the things that you have to do first when applying the ecosystem assessment approach is to look at the state of ecosystems, and here we presented the Mancha Humeda ecosystems. You have very different states, but all of them are equally important. And that's very useful, because just in the year that Tablas de Daimiel suffered the worst fire in the all the years that we have records, all these lakes in Mancha Húmeda were flooded with water, all of them, even those that we thought in 1999 that had disappeared, all of them. Actually, the only places that were not flooded were Tablas de Daimiel and Ojos del Guadiana ones. So this is the importance of the network again. So there are some recommendations. I will not go through all of them, but we have to do a wise use of them in several aspects and so. And then, another tool of the Millennium Assessment Ecosystems are the drivers of change, that are the impacts, the sources of impact in the terminology of the MIA. In the case of La Mancha wetlands are these ones, and you have the possibility to classify both the importance of the intensity of the driver of change and also the trend. And even if the intensity of the driver of change is not so important, like for example alien species or other impacts, the trend is increasing very quickly, and then you have to worry a little bit in this case. Again, this mouse. Yeah, then you have to be ready for different restoration activities at different scales. And another possibility is to go not in a overall way, like the one I showed you in the previous slide, but looking at even these ones are a bit synthesized, but you can go service by service, and you can assess service by service separately. And then you get the state, the trend that is decreasing, increasing, or stable for the different services you get, like here. To correct these trends, you have to count with the stakeholder, with the local people. Even if the managers have the responsibility to take the decisions, you have to take into account the opinion of the local people. Then we have some examples of indicators, like, for example, in Campo de Calatrava volcanic field, that is one of the areas that deserve the consideration of biosphere reserve, apart from Mancha Húmeda in Castilla-La Mancha, that is very diverse region in terms of types of ecosystems. One of the provision, because these lakes are freshwater lakes, is to reclaim them for agriculture. You can find lots of lakes that are drained, like this one. Regarding the regulation services, for example, we've got three slides about how much wetlands may suppose in terms of saving money from the money that are devoted to cleaning in plant treatment zones or plant treatments, industrial treatments, and so on, that are increasingly high because of the cost of electricity. So that's a very important one. And natural wetlands and created wetlands can help to save money. And we have used, in this case, in general, in the Millennium Assessment ecosystems, you try to use indicators that are taken from easy sources, like the National Institute of Statistics, and very, very simple to obtain data. Okay, this is I jumped the total nitrogen, but here you have the total phosphorus, and there are some decreasing trends in savings, of course, due to the problems in the maintenance of some of these sites. This has to be coordinated, of course, with several national and international policies, like the Water Framework Directive and some others. You can assess also cultural services. There was a PhD in our group in 2010. And there was a girl, Elena, who assessed the all the services related to connectivity that were associated to the mobility of human populations throughout the landscape, and how the changes in the landscape, the improvement of roads and better and broader roads, what supposes fragmenting the landscape, and also the hydraulic infrastructures are just breaking all the connectivity in rivers. And then we made some this kind of analysis. We have also cultural services. We have in Villafranca de los Caballeros, here in the province of Toledo, the Playas de la Mancha. That is the Mancha Beach, I don't know. where you can take therapeutic bath with this sapropelic mud. This is a salt, black mud, rich in organic matter. Apart from being, well, a nice time, you can enjoy it. It does function for reuma or whatever. It goes okay. Then we enter, if we do not put any solution, we enter in this kind of cycles where yeah, now the population tends to concentrate upright up in the slide in cities, then governments try to help with subsidies the population in rural areas to stay there and not going to cities, but then not the young people doesn't want to do it, and then population is still decreasing in rural areas and is aging, and so on, and this triggers a change. This is a direct driver of change, and then progressively we lost. There's a loss in biogeochemical cycles. There's an overexploitation of water resources, and in general, all these kind of land use changes. And as a result, we lost some part of natural capital, and there are losses of services. There are less food diversity, more regulation of water, more damage because of perturbations. When floods come, perhaps vineyards occupy all the fluvial space of freedom, and then you have less transhumans, less nomadism, less local knowledge because people doesn't identify so well with the ecosystems. They start to lose. The old people dies, and then they cannot transmit the knowledge to the young people. Then for this is very important. Also, even for maintaining tourism programs, to increase public awareness in the region, in the local people, and trying to also the scientists and researchers try to communicate all the knowledge. And the proposal that I finally tried to show to you is something like a tsunami model, because we know, I show you like Villafranca de los Caballeros, but there are also other towns and villages in La Mancha. Not they don't do everything well, but they do many things well. And the proposal is that, okay, we are going to support all the programs in these few places where the things operate. And we are going to let aside all this irrigation agriculture with pivots and so that are the monoculture that doesn't function anymore, because it is based on agrarian subsidies and this kind of things. And what we try to do in this map of the connections of the network that I showed you before is to try to use these tsunamis to extend the best available practices that are being doing since years in a few places all throughout the network, and not only in very small places within the fence of the natural reserves. And biosphere reserves are not isolated islands. They should be managed in the context of, if they are wetlands, in the context of the river catchments, the basins. We have to use in tourism programs the ecological corridors, and we have to plan the touristic activities along them and also across them. Like I showed you, I don't know if you realize that there was the forts, the battles, and also the old bridges in the table I showed you before that are very important. There are, in some countries, there are huge problems only about forts, only for battles, for preserving the battles. We have very few battles left in rivers. And that's a pity, for example. That's one of them. And finally, what we have to do, we have stakeholders to involve, scientists, also conservationists, of course, the managers. What we have to do is taking risks. In Spanish, it's hay que mojarse. Okay. Thanks.
Okay.